Bahrain is an island, but imagine, ladies and gentlemen, Bahrain is island without coasts. People do not see the shores. Just only 20% of the Bahraini shores are being seen by the Bahraini people, because all have been taken over by the royal family. Below here, you cannot, but you need a special permission to go down, because this is all private property being taken by the king.
It is, you know, the UK is trying to basically throw away every ethic or morals that they claim to have, or every principles that they claim to defend, for the sake of capitalism, because one king has more money to throw at them than the people of Bahrain, and is essentially saying that if you have might and money, then you will be protected. It's not fair, it's not just.
Over 79 visits by 52 different parliamentarians and their staff between 2007 and 2017, the overwhelming majority of which was paid for by the government of Bahrain or public institutions there, which question the independence of the findings of those parliamentarians and their fact-finding missions. This totals almost £100,000 that's been paid for by the government of Bahrain on UK parliamentarians attending the Manama Dialogue, which is held up as an event to show the legitimacy of the regime, despite some of the activities that have been mentioned earlier.
Have to be returned to the people. It's being stolen, confiscated by the royal family. The international community should recognize
نحن لابد ان نقوم بواجبنا وتكليفنا نوضح الى العالم كله هذا الوجه الاسود لهذا النظام الذي يحاول أن يخفيه، وعبر الحقائق، عبر الصور والوثائق الدامغة، عبر التقارير الموثقة، نقول إلى العالم أن هذه هي الحقيقة.
جزء من الأموال التي نهبت من ثروة أبناء شعب البحرين موجودة هنا في بريطانيا، وبالتالي هناك أسباب كثيرة تدعونا إلى ملاحقته وتدعونا إلى دعوة الحكومة البريطانية في عدم استقباله وإلغاء هذه الزيارة، وبالتالي هذه الأسباب كلها تدعونا إلى ملاحقة حمد عيسى الخليفة حاكم البحرين، وتؤكد علينا يوما بعد يوم أن هذا النضال السياسي لابد أن يستمر إلى حين أن يحصل أبناء شعبنا على جميع حقوقهم.